Hi, I'm Naomi.
I'm Katie.
And welcome to Last TV Gaming News, bringing all the gaming news straight from South Korea.
After a will they, won't they dance for nearly 5 months, PUBG Corp has decided that they won't. And they're dropping the lawsuit against Epic Games.
The copyright infringement suit was initially filed back in January, with PUBG Corp claiming that Epic had copied key elements of PUBG for their own Battle Royale Fortnite. PUBG Corp has confirmed that a letter of withdrawal was sent to Epic Games' legal team last week, and the case has been closed. No further information, such as reasoning or whether out-of-court action like a settlement had been reached, was provided. Whilst their contention with Epic may be settled, PUBG Corp are still currently in a process of suing Chinese publishers NetEase for copyright infringement over its Battle Royale mobile titles, Rules of Survival and Knives Out.
And with the lawsuit off of their hands, PUBG now has plenty of time to put off fixing those bugs and pursue other endeavors, like launching a collection with Fila.
Can you really call yourself a PUBG fan if you're not playing it whilst decked out in camo print slippers, military-style logo tees, or why not a triple pouch utility belt perfect for storing snacks for when you can't rely on those chicken dinners? The collection is available for purchase on the official Fila site.
Ever wish the Korean story-driven MMORPG had a little more Battle Royale du jour flair? Well, your wish might have been answered, with players discovering a potential Battle Royale map within server files for the latest Blade and Soul update. The Korean servers for Blade and Soul just received a huge summer update, introducing the newest class, which is yet to be officially named in English. But a Chinese gamer delved a little deeper into the update and found an unused map hidden within the files. Of course, there are no details, but the design does seem to infer a Battle Royale-esque setup. Is Blade and Soul coming for some of that sweet, sweet Battle Royale action? Only time will tell. We'll be sure to keep an eye on this, as I'm sure PUBG Corp also are, and keep you updated with any new information.
Korean-developed MMO Bless Online has had somewhat of a rocky start internationally, but it looks like NeoWiz is looking to patch things up with some server solutions announced in their latest producer's letter.
Executive producer Sung Jin-ko published the letter on Steam last week. It stated that the Bless team has been working with Amazon Web Services to address stability issues, and will also consolidate its existing servers. The servers will be reduced down to 2 North American and 2 European servers. As to when this is planned to take place, no one knows just yet, but Ko did say that players would be given ample notice in advance as to where their characters and items will end up.
After first being teased back in 2016, Action Square's mobile action RPG Blade 2, The Return of Evil, has finally launched. Despite being a mobile title, Blade 2 boasts Unreal Engine 4 graphics with the cinematic gameplay focused around a mammoth storyline. The game is currently only available in South Korea, but there have been hints of a planned Western release. Kakao Games holds the global rights, and certain characters have been covered up since the beta in typical East to West fashion, and Kakao Games even uploaded a teaser trailer featuring an all-star cast of English voice actors. No Western release date has been scheduled as of yet, but if you can't wait to get your hands on the game, you can download the Korean version, which has English audio options.
The summer tournament announcement count is still on the rise. Ubisoft announced last week that it will be hosting the Rainbow Six Korea Cup for its eponymous FPS.
The tournament will be a permanent event split into a weekly cup, monthly cup, and quarterly cup, all held online. It's open to all Rainbow Six players and teams to compete for their chance to win in-game credits and prizes. The quarterly cup will carry the most prestige, with teams selected from the victors of the monthly cups competing for up to 3 million won. The cup will run through the fourth quarter of this year. The tournament will be hosted by Ubisoft and operated by Big Picture Interactive.
And lastly, prolific online game developers Nexon have announced that it has adopted flexible working hours.
This move follows in the footsteps of other major Korean game firms like NCSoft and Netmarble. The Korean gaming industry was once notorious for its intense work culture, with the unfortunate passing of 3 Netmarble employees sending death by overwork headlines across the world. The new flexi hour system allows employees to choose their work hours to allow them to schedule their day around personal affairs and leisure activities. The system also excludes hours after 10 p.m. Nexon officially implemented the new system July 1st.
There may not have been any official matches played in the last week, but there has been plenty of action off of the servers, perhaps a little too much action, all revolving around what is shaping up to be the Korean scene's 3 favorite topics: account shenanigans, apologies, and roster shakeups. Matabellum lit the fuse back at the Contenders group draw last week when they revealed that they had made the controversial decision to sign Happy, a player previously known by the battle tag Vesta, who had a well-known history in boosting. After a lot of shade throwing from industry players and insiders, Matabellum finally posted an official statement regarding the signing. They posted a letter on Twitter explaining their decision to leave Happy's boosting discretions in the past, believing that his releases from his previous teams and self-reflection were punishment enough. Going forward, they vowed that his earnings from Season 2 would be donated to the Overwatch community, including the 87,000 won, around 7 to 8 US dollars, he made from boosting. But Happy was not the only roster addition to Matabellum last week. Flex support Won J Lee has also joined the team, an addition that is undoubtedly easier for Matabellum fans to get hyped about. It was a busy week for O2 Ardeont as they took to Twitter to officially respond to allegations regarding, well, pretty much everything, from match fixing to unsavory online behaviour. O2's coach Jin Seok-hoon denied the accusations of match fixing and stated that an investigation had already declared him not guilty back at the start of February. He also provided evidence that he was not associated with the rather unsavory online community, Ilbe. Lastly, he explained some questionable neighbour postings and account sharing. O2 Ardeont stated that they would support their coach and forgive all of those who spread false information before July 3rd, but if they catch anyone doing so post July 3rd, they shouldn't be too surprised to be slapped with a lawsuit. O2's pseudo-sister team also had some boosting-related business to deal with as their flex player, Really, was accused of being a former booster. Really actually responded with a handwritten letter admitting the accusations were indeed true. He stated that after discussing the matter with O2's GM, he wrote a confession, if you will, and submitted it to Blizzard along with evidence to await their judgment on whether he was fit to play or not. Unfortunately, Blizzard allegedly did not respond, and his name was submitted for WGS H2's Season 2 roster with no issues. It looks like Seven couldn't escape the boosting brush this week either, as they released an official statement regarding allegations against their tank, Evo. The team will be conducting an internal investigation and will reveal the results soon. An Element Mystic hit a bump in their road to redemption as their star DPS Sparkle was found guilty of account selling. The org made a post on InVen detailing the indiscretion that happened last year, and that they will be suspending him from playing in Contender Season 2 as a result. However, while they admitted that he did sell accounts, they took the time to deny accompanying rumours of his association with Ilbe. With one player down, Element Mystic also announced that they picked up ex-Runaway and Meta Athena tank Alpha to join the roster for the upcoming season, which, of course, all kicks off tomorrow.
There's a good news for Final Fantasy fans. The official Distant World concert tour will be making a stop in Seoul in September. The event will be held in the Lotte Concert Hall and will showcase the very best of the Final Fantasy soundtrack, including classics from previous Distant World programs, as well as new editions from Final Fantasy XV. If you missed out on the Radiant of Light concert last month, then be sure to go to Interpark and get your ticket for Distant World. Be quick, they are known to sell out fast.
As for us here at Lattice TV, we have a review for Mazem's Jekyll and Hyde mobile game up on our Medium, so be sure to check it out.
We're also working on an article and video about everyone's favorite pink-clad Overwatch team, Runaway, so be sure to keep an eye out for that too.
Okay, so that's it for today. See you next week.
Bye-bye.